I'm Dr. Hannah Boslaars, working for Medics for the People. I'm a general practitioner here in a medical action center in Molenbeek. We combine accessible healthcare with local and national action for the right to health. Well, as a medical student, I was already attracted to social medicine. I did one mission with Doctors Without Borders in Mali, in Africa, where I saw that without health system, the population is completely in a catastrophic state, and it made me more convinced of the values of social medicine. It made me completely convinced of my place here in Molenbeek with Medics for the People. When we saw this first wave coming, it was very frightening because we didn't have any protocols. Outside of the hospitals, we didn't have any protection material either, and it all went very fast. There were already protests going on among healthcare workers in 2019. For better working conditions, for more colleagues to care for the patient instead of care for the profits of the hospital. So we are in a very fragile system, and that is especially because of privatization, commercialization, and lack of public funding since many, many years. It's not new, and this was the major reason of the collapse of our hospitals. In June, when our minister, Sophie Wilmès, visited public hospital in Brussels, the healthcare workers of Saint-Pierre Hospital in Brussels turned their back. It was a very strong symbol of unified resistance of healthcare workers. So this action led also to a manifestation in September. 13th of September, we were 5,000 healthcare workers in the center of Brussels. And afterwards, there was 600 million liberated for hiring the wages of healthcare workers. So this was a major victory of syndical action, a strike as well. I think we reached a point of almost no return. We will need to analyze what happened during this crisis and make conclusions and change our system.